the more powerful AI grows, the more the need to actually have proper regulation. And in fact, AI has been left unregulated up till now, but I think now is the time when AI is starting to show the signs of being powerful enough that a proper ethical and legal framework is put into place. I think as AI capabilities increase, there are limited applications where it can help the decision-making process. If you've got a small claim in court, AI can actually help in making that kind of decision. We can bring AI tech from the theory to the practical in a variety of ways. All the AI has been developed over the years, since the 50s actually. Most of the algorithms that are in use right now have been developed in the 80s and the late 90s. And slowly, the availability of hardware and the availability of data that can actually run these algorithms has led to the fueling of this current wave of AI. And AI is now here to stay. There were attempts in the past to get AI in a practical way, but unfortunately, while the ideas were good, the actual practical implementation wasn't fast enough and good enough for everyday use. So what we're doing is to see all the different theoretical approaches and making practical implementations of them, implementations that can fit on a phone and ideally that will need less bandwidth and less communication constant via, you know, data centers and all that. For example, if you've used a digital assistant, every time that you speak, that speech is being sent to a data center somewhere, being transcribed and being matched, and the results sent back. It would be much better if the device could actually do that in your home without any privacy issues and getting it directly to you. So I see that there is a very well thought out process, and this is now pretty much honed out on how to turn the theory into reality. And I think we're gonna see a lot of advances. I think AI and regulation is very important. First of all, if you have AI that is left unchecked, at the moment it's not really such a problem, but the more powerful AI grows, the more the need to actually have proper regulation. And in fact, AI has been left unregulated up till now, but I think now is the time when AI is starting to show the signs of being powerful enough that a proper ethical and legal framework is put into place. I think there are two main advantages of having a proper regulatory approach. One is when it comes to regulated industries and the question of liability. If you have driverless cars running around, who is going to be liable when accidents inevitably will occur? What happens if you have an AI system that damages property? And all that, you'll have all these issues. So without a proper legal regulation in place, we will have problems. The second is also in providing guidelines to developers on how to do things right. I'm sure that everyone agrees that we do not want to be living in a society where AI is used to oppress citizens. For example, what is being done with the social score system, in which the control may be something that is unacceptable to audiences that are living in a more democratic state, where you will have people choosing what to do and not to do it in the terms of the law, rather than having an AI system that is forcing you, whether you like it or not, to choose a particular behavior. So I think all these issues are really ripe for regulation. And the third pillar would be obviously to get attract foreign investment and also enable local startups to flourish in Malta. I think that, well, we're still far off from having AI making the kind of decisions where AI will decide whether we've got, you know, a particular society decision or replace political parties entirely. I actually think that humans should be in control when it comes to decisions that impact a large amount of people's lives. Even if it impacts one person's life, I think that those decisions should be reviewed by people. Obviously, I think as AI capabilities increase, there are limited applications where it can help the decision-making process. For example, if you've got a small claim in court, AI, since it is a very codified system of law, can actually help in making that kind of decision. If you've got questions about a particular audit, for example, or whether, you know, you are in compliance or not, those kind of scenarios where with a narrow amount of rules effectively and codified knowledge, I think that is where AI will really help. And when it comes to more, you know, human and soft decisions. I think that we're far away from that. But AI can at least help us make an informed decision. So I see it as a tool that assists rather than replaces people. Yes, the Malta Blockchain Summit is AI and Blockchain Summit. Has been always good. The last edition, the first edition was quite fantastic. Now we're seeing also a very quicker update cycle because of the two editions every year. I think it has been an exciting event that brings about interesting audiences. And you can see there is a different type of audience that is interested in AI and blockchain. You can actually see the differences. And I think this is the importance in having different viewpoints and different skill sets put together, mingling together, and obviously giving rise, hopefully, to something that is great.